Quran chapter 11, verse 30, lesson 1407. Title is Fear of Allah, Surah Huud. I seek refuge in God from Satan the outcast. In the name of God, the Beneficent, the Merciful. Verse 30. And O my people, who would deliver me from Allah if I thrust them away? Will ye not then reflect? Commentary. Messenger Noah, peace be upon him, said that all human beings are creatures of Allah Almighty, and according to it, all are equal. I don't have any right to make groups of the people on the basis of temporary splendor, wealth, and property, and let just those people come unto me who consider themselves on a higher status in the world. This is the matter, self-fabricated by themselves. Allah Almighty has fixed the status of the world as worthless. Now think a little while about it, that how can I say to such people who come to me for hearing the message of Allah Almighty that I have no time for them, they should not come unto me? Or those who already have been sitting near me, should I thrust them away? If I did so, Allah Almighty would punish me for such conduct because it is disobedience of His command. Then who will save me from the wrath of Allah Almighty? Why will Allah Almighty listen to the recommendation of you proud and wealthy people? Recommendations are heard by the greedy governors of the world because they receive gifts and bribes from the wealthy people. When the time comes, they need their favor. Otherwise, their superior people will be displeased from them. Allah is the strongest ruler. Bribe and recommendation is not acceptable to Him. Do you not have any sense of thinking about it, and that you should not talk improperly? This verse is saying very clearly that caste, race and sect, wealth and property, riches and poverty, nation and country are nothing. The man who is king and sitting on the throne is fully equal of that person before Allah Almighty, who works hard for livelihood of himself and his family. However, if that poor person believes in Allah Almighty and worships Him, then he is better than the king near Allah Almighty. Urdu mein samaat farmaiye, unwan hai Allah ka khauf. A'udhu billahi minash-Shay-taanir-Rajiim. Bis-Millaahir-Rahmaanir-Rahiim. Wa yaa-qawmi minyan-surunii minAllaahi tarat-tuhum Afa-laa tazak-karuun. Aur ae kaum, mujhko Allah se kaun chhudavega agar main unhein haank doon? Kya tum dhyan nahi karte? Hazrat Nuh alaihi salam farmate hain ki tamam insaan Allah ki makhlooq hain aur is etbaar se sab ek dusre ke barabar hain. Mujhe koi haq nahi ki main duniya ki aarzi baal o daulat jah o jalal ki bina par logon ke groh qaim karun aur faqat unhi logon ko apne paas aane dun jo duniya mein apne aap ko bade martabe wale samajhte hain. Ye khud unki mangharat baat hai. Allah taala ne duniya ke martabe ko hej qarar diya hai. اب ذرا سوچو کہ میں ان غریب غربا کو جو میرے پاس اللہ کا پیغام سننے آتے ہیں کس منہ سے کہہ دوں کہ تمہارے لیے میرے پاس وقت نہیں, تم میرے پاس مت آؤ, اور جو آئے بیٹھے ہوں انہیں دستکار کا نکال دوں. اگر میں ایسا کروں تو اللہ تعالیٰ مجھے اس کی سزا دے گا, کیونکہ یہ اس کی نافرمانی ہے. پھر مجھے اس کے غضب سے کون بچائے گا؟ Allah Ta'ala, tum magroor maaldaron ko, tum magroor maaldaron ki sifarish kyun sunne laga? Sifarishe to dunya ke laalchi hakim suna karte hain, kyunki unke paas maaldaron ki taraf se rishwatein aur tohfe tohaif bhi pahunchte rehte hain, aur unhe waqt aane par unki riayat zaruri hai, warna wo bade log unse naraaz ho jayenge. Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala to ahkamul hakimin hai, uske haan sifarish aur rishwat kuch nahi chalti. क्या तुम में इतनी अकल नहीं कि इन बातों को सोचो और नामुनासिब बातें मुंह से ना निकालो. यह आयत साफ कह रही है कि जात पात मालदारी मुफलसी नस्ल मुल्क कौम कोई चीज़ नहीं. अल्लाह ताला की निगाह में वो शख्स जो तख्त पर बादशाह बना बैठा है और वो शख्स जो खून पसीना एक करके अपना और अपने कुंबे का पेट पालता है दोनों बिल्कुल बराबर हैं. बल्कि अगर ये गरीब اللہ تعالیٰ کو مانتا ہے اور اس کی بندگی کرتا ہے تو اس بادشاہ سے اللہ تعالیٰ کے نزدیک کہیں بہتر ہے. صدق اللہ مولانا العظیم وصدق رسوله النبی الامی الکریم.